Hello, I received this parcel from the Hong Kong Mail Store. It contains two identical puzzles. They are being sold as the Ghost Pyraminx. I'm going to talk about that name later, because I don't think it's quite right. The puzzle is based on a skewed mechanism, although it's not made by Meffetz. At present it's only available in blue plastic, with these kind of black carbon type stickers. You don't need different colours by the way, because it's solved by shape alone. Movement is pretty good, and it has those little ball bearings and springs, which means each move clicks into place. It's lightly lubed, but not enough to make the outside greasy. As you can see, it shape shifts, and it gets quite weird when you really scramble it. It's definitely a nice quality puzzle, so I would recommend it. If you're interested in getting one, use a link in my description. Now for disassembly. Knowing it's a skewed mechanism means I can prise out a piece that's the equivalent to a centre. It has extra little anti-pop lips, identical to Meffetz's latest skewed-based puzzles. I think these were first seen in Speed Cubes, though I'm not sure. Now for assembly. I thought it would be really easy, though the design makes it a bit tricky. It's one of those puzzles where the screws are not fully covered by plastic when assembled. So when disassembled down to the spider, the four parts still attached are pulled further towards the core by the springs. Meaning, when you assemble it, you are kind of fighting against those springs. Another thing that makes it tricky is the fact that all the parts are different, and the solved state is a part move away from the mechanism's normal solved position. So basically you have to plan your assembly by getting parts ready and make sure the four parts attached to the core are correctly orientated. It also has to be held fairly carefully so parts can't fly out. I know some of you like the natural sounds of assembly, so I'll shut up for a couple of minutes. More information later though. The last part of this video is going to be about the name and what it should or shouldn't be called. I'm doing this because there seems to be a lot of confusion about it. It's being sold as a Ghost pyraminx. Some people are saying it's a ghost helping Maya tetrahedron. Other people are saying it's a ghost Jing's pyraminx. So let's go through all that. So where did all this start? Well, in the late 90s, I took a regular Mephits cube and I turned it like that. And then I built a cube around that. And that, of course, is my golden cube. Many years after that, Adam Cohen copied the same idea and applied it to a regular Rubik's cube. And he made a ghost cube. Now, both of these puzzles have been named after the colouring. Obviously, golden cube's golden, ghost cube, because it kind of has this ghostly appearance. I think possibly the originals were white stickers on a black background, but I forget. But the colouring became insignificant because later on there was a mass-produced black golden cube, a mass-produced copper golden cube, a mass-produced silver golden cube, and I made various colours myself. So the golden part just kind of was a description of what it was rather than its colouring, if that makes sense. Exactly the same thing happened with the ghost cube. This has a ghostly appearance. But the red ghost cube doesn't have a ghostly appearance. It has nothing to do with a ghost. So it's the same thing. So don't be mistaken by the names. You know, it's misleading, I know, to call it golden cube and ghost cube. But, you know, that's the way things have kind of evolved. Well, of course, that predates that one. And it was the first one. So in theory, everything nowadays similar should be called golden. But that became more well known, the ghost kind of setup, so it's kind of up to you which you want to call it. Now, if we jump to the ghost pyraminx, well, let's compare it to a pyraminx. Apart from a shape, there is nothing that, you know, there's no comparison between the two, so it's definitely not a ghost pyraminx or a golden pyraminx. So that's just nonsense. So what actually is it? Well, some people are calling it a ghost Jing's pyraminx. Well, it's not technically wrong, but Jing's pyraminx is a pillowed version of the Halpin Maya tetrahedron. And this came out many, many years before Jing's pyraminx, so it's kind of like a bit back to front to use Jing's pyraminx as a name. This one I made myself, but you know, it was invented many years ago by Halpin and Maya. So I think it is based on this, basically. So it's like a part turn version of that, and kind of reconfigured, let's say. Now, so then the question is it a ghost Halpin Maya tetrahedron, or is it a golden Halpin Maya tetrahedron? I would argue that in theory it should be a golden Halpin Maya tetrahedron. But I accept that things change, and it's much, you know, the ghost concept is much more known. It's the same concept, but it's the name is more well known now. So I think it should be called Ghost Halpin Maya tetrahedron. Although I might occasionally call it Golden Halpin Maya tetrahedron, just to be awkward.